Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ. Whether it's on a Sunday, Tuesday, or Friday, or any other day of the week, a warm welcome awaits you at Divine Destiny Worship Center, a place where your full potential is discovered. Here's a special invitation to join us at our sanctuary for today's...
The Lord says to us, if you will obey my commandments indeed, then you will be blessed in the city, blessed in the field, blessed in your house, blessed in your yard, blessed in the fruit of your hands. And we extend that to Isaiah 1:19. What I just quoted there was Deuteronomy 28. Isaiah 1:19 says this, if I am willing and am obedient, I will eat the good of the land. And the very first command God gave us was that we be fruitful and multiply, replenish. It's a five-layer concentric circle system of living. Every time we receive from God, He's expecting us to expand. Yes, there is nothing wrong in having more money than you need as a kingdom citizen. In fact, I dare say to you, it is a testimony of the ability of your King of Kings and Lord of Lords to sustain you through seasons. In fact, I dare say to you that God does not operate by the economy of your nation. God's economy actually allows you to prosper even in times of adversity. And I'm here to prophesy to you, above all, you shall prosper and be in health. And we are talking all this prosperity thing because this is the month leading up to our big expo coming up, our business expo on the 2nd of September. Good morning, I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan. On behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters of Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, welcoming you to this program. It's your date with destiny. And we've been talking to you, ministering to you about wealth for the last while. Why are we doing that? We want to stir up your pure minds so that on the day when we have the exhibition, which comes in a two-part program, the morning we are having from 9 to 12, thereabouts, we are having lectures on retirement financing. We're going to hear from the president of a credit union. We're going to hear from an insurance agent. We're going to hear from a business operator. And we're going to hear from me, of course, an apostle, a pastor who refused to buy in to the poverty gospel. We want the people at Divine Destiny and by extension, the kingdom of God, to prosper, because that's God's command. He say, above all, prosper. He didn't say, oh, if you want to, you could either prosper or live on a box of food from the government or the church. No, he said, I want you to prosper above all. Amen? So I want you to take some principles from this next excerpt of one of the messages I preached in a series pertaining to wealth. You are entitled to be wealthy in the name of Jesus.
I said it in this house over and over, the Bible that we have, that people have used to impoverish us because of wrong thinking and wrong interpretation of what Jesus wants for the kingdom people. Other people who don't believe in Jesus are using the same Bible and making millions of dollars every year. Les Brown and all those guys, all their principles come from Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Psalms, Luke, whatever Paul wrote. They copy that. I said, copy it. I wish God could make me the tax collector for all of them who are using the Bible to make money. And then go and talk to all the preachers who've been preaching a poverty gospel. I want you to understand, many ministers are afraid to talk about money in the church because they don't want to be labeled prosperity preacher. Well, this is one preacher that's not afraid of that. Because if we don't prosper, we can't put the building up over the road. And when we check the scripture, the very first command God gave to man was to prosper. He said, be fruitful. He didn't tell him get saved. He didn't tell him cast out devils. He said, be fruitful. So it's right at the top of God's agenda for me as a man, you as a man, you as a woman, me as a kingdom citizen, is that I prosper. And the word prosper has a different layers. One of them for sure is to fulfill destiny. But you can never fulfill destiny without money. Are you hearing me? Oh, my destiny is to be poor. Well, good. You don't need the money. Send it by me. But if I truly understand what destiny means, and destiny really means to fulfill purpose, and if purpose in the kingdom is connected to God, then it has to be that I need the resources that God has released in the kingdom and released in the earth for me to fulfill destiny. Are you hearing me? Good. And I want us to go into Luke chapter 19. I know the first part is about Zacchaeus. But I want us to take from verse 12. Let's go from verse 12. When you get a chance, you read the story of Zacchaeus, not just that he was a short man that climbed a tree. You will see what happened when Zacchaeus encountered Jesus. His attitude changed. And one of the things we are teaching more and more wherever we travel is that poverty is more a result of bad attitude than lack of money. Bad thinking. If you're going to prosper, if you're going to make a sense of what's happening around you, if you're going to make sense of the money that comes into you by way of wages or salary or gifts, your mind has to change. Are you hearing me? You're going to have all the principles laid down right there. We know of people who have masters in management, but they're poor. What's the sense of having an MBA and you can't pay bills? Because having the education doesn't make a difference unless your attitude changes. Are you hearing me? And this parable is absolutely important. Now, in the King James, it says the man gives a pound, 1 pound, whatever that was worth in those days, to each person, and said to them, let's read together, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. And he called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds and said unto them, occupy till I come. Now, I have a translation here, the New Century Version. Hear what he says to them. He says, do business. Do what? Business with this money. Do business. This is Jesus, the one who everybody has profiled as a poor man. Now, if we accept Jesus to be poor, then we followers cannot outrun Jesus. We're going to be as poor as he is. But I've already profiled for those of you here in church that Jesus began life with an endowment. His mother and father were rich. They were not poor. Because the answer to the question, or the answer that says there is no room in the inn it could not be to the question, do you have a stable? The question had to be, do you have room in the inn? So the natural answer is, we didn't get your WhatsApp your WhatsApp text, so all rooms used up. So hear what? I know your wife ready to, but we have a stable. We're going to clean it. I'll send the boys to clean it. Nobody goes to Hyatt front desk and ask for a room if you don't have the ability to pay. They will laugh you out of there, boy, or drag you. I don't know which one, but they'll get you out of there. So Joseph and Mary were not poor people. They were rich because they went to the inn. In those days, the inn was the hotel. So when Jesus was born, and then the kings came and gave him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. All of them were commercial goods, goods that could have been used just like money to buy and sell. Because in those days, they had money transactions, monetary transactions, but they also had bartering transactions, where you could have exchanged goods for goods. Right. It tells me then that this Jesus we are serving wants us to prosper. And if he takes the time to give a parable, and in the parable, he is speaking on behalf, or speaking concerning the rich man who is going to get a kingdom, which really is Jesus himself, because he had to go away to come back to get this kingdom of the earth when the time comes. He goes away and he says, occupy until I come. But you really, the modern translation says what? Do business until I come. In Spanish, the word for business is ocupación. Ocupación, which means they understand it from the original language.
I'm anointing my hands today, again, and I'm stretching forth my hands to deal with people who had money, but you didn't manage it well. And now you're back at square one. Some people at square zero. But I want to prophesy to you that God is ready to take you back up the ladder. I'm breaking the back of lack. I am digging out the guts of poverty itself. And I'm releasing to you the ability to manage what God gives to you. In fact, I'm introducing you to the manager of all managers of affairs in the earth. Who is he? Holy Spirit. Jesus said of him, I'm going away, but I'm sending you another comforter. The Greek word is parakletos, meaning he will hook up with you, hook you under your arm, tie your left leg to him, and gonna run with you so that you get a sense that you are not alone. I prophesy, part of his portfolio is to lead you into all truths. And there's a truth about managing money. No, I'm not talking about what you get when you do MBAs and so on, because a lot of people with MBAs can't pay the bills. I prophesy you are going to hear what the Holy Spirit have to say. Receive it right now. You are going back up the ladder. Amen. Well, we are just 3 weekends away from our big expo. Hallelujah. As I told you, we will be having a two-part day. The first half is lectures, because my philosophy is just the same as John F. Kennedy said, give a man a fish and you'll have to give him a fish every day. Teach him how to fish and he never comes back to you for a fish. I'm here to say, give a man a business and you don't teach him, you are actually giving him, like the cowboy with the 2 guns loaded, and you didn't teach him, he must level the gun first, straighten it first, before he shoots. So he pulls it out and shoots out his big toes. Yeah, he should have defended himself but he became his own worst enemy. I am here to tell you, we are having our expo. Why not call, ask for 10 tickets, bring your family, even bring those who are not yet working, those who are at school, bring them, because I'm finding out more and more. If I had known some of the things I now know at 65, if I had known that at 20 when I started to work, I'll be much better off concerning finances. So the theme of our exhibition is micro-enterprises, the master key to retirement financing. Let me ask you this question. If you were to retire today, and may I tell you, retirement does not mean that you have come to the age. There are companies that are retiring their people, offering them a retirement package. If you get the offer of retirement package, can you take it and still live at the same level as if you were getting a salary? Those are some of the things we'll be talking about. On the 2nd of September, the first Saturday in September, when we have our business expo, Expo is We 2017. Do not miss it. Amen? Good. So we have our radio programs coming up every week. Monday, 98.1, 9 o'clock p.m. It's your date with destiny. On Tuesday, 107.1, the word, 9:30 p.m., living the more abundant life. And what we do with that, it's sponsored by Bee's Ice Cream. And we try to motivate people to get their dream come to pass during that program. And of course, at 3 p.m. every Friday, we have Ask Pastor Gemma, the program at which few people dare to ask certain questions, and even fewer dare to answer. Apostle Gemma dares to answer those questions. And this is weekend. We have our service. Now, we want you to know, for the entire month of August, even into the 1st of September, the Friday before our exhibition, we will not have any Friday night services, neither here at Divine Destiny nor in our branches. Our branches will continue with their Wednesday services. It's going to be awesome. We give God the praise for Him giving us the wisdom to follow His plan for our lives. Why not be encouraged by one of our would-be exhibitors to come to our expo? Hear that person with the excitement that they have.
The Bible declares that He has raised us up together and has made us sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Hi, my name is Catherine Bettel, and I'm a covenanter here at Divine Destiny Worship Center. I'm also the managing director and co-founder of Bee's Ice Cream, and I'm happy to present to you one of our events that is coming up on the 2nd of September 2017. The concept behind this event is micro-enterprise, the master key to retirement financing. Why? We know that micro-enterprises, entrepreneurship, business development is something that adds value to all of our lives. So what we have been doing coming out of Burton, this seminar and this expo last year, where we would have mentored, we coached, we trained, we even ministered to our covenanters here about how to start a business, how to finance your business, how to grow your business. This year, 2017, we have so many success stories, so many praise reports about the great things the Lord has been doing at Divine Destiny Worship Center. So I am inviting you to come and experience who we are at Divine Destiny Worship Center. This year we are saying Expo is We 2017. You will see a display, an amalgamation of all the God-given talents and businesses and ideas that are birthed right here at Divine Destiny Worship Center. But before you can experience a taste of Divine Destiny or to see the display of creative lamps or even hairstylists and makeup artists and services and all of that and attorneys and business owners and so forth, before we believe in training up and developing our covenanters. So the day will begin with a seminar. And the seminar is entitled Micro Enterprise, the Master Key to Retirement Financing or Future Financing. Why is that so important? Many of us, or some of us, already have our pensions in place, or some people might be thinking about putting aside a pension for their future or for their retirement. But here's where the problem is that inflation normally eats up that. So therefore, when you are ready to look at your pension down the road, maybe 10, 15, 20 years down the road, 30 years down the road, the money that is required to take care of yourself would not be sufficient. From my experience, my husband right now is watching as his retirement. And what is he seeing? Not enough money to take care of him right now. What is taking care of us today? Business, enterprise, putting your God-given talents in place so that you can generate the needed cash and finances to take care of yourself, to take care of your family, or to take care of any needs that you may have. So we are saying, come into the House of Divine Destiny Worship Center on the 2nd of September, 2017. Come and hear, you know, from the learned persons in the field, persons who have the competencies in financial planning. Come and hear about the tools, or come and hear about new ideas or ways that you can develop your God-given talent. In addition, be ministered by our Apostle Vivian Duncan. When we are finished with that expo, you will have an experience of a lifetime. You will see the showcase of God's excellence right here at Divine Destiny Worship Center, because we are Expo specialists at Divine Destiny Worship Center. Expo is we 2017. You will see over 75 businesses and services and skills demonstrated here at Divine Destiny Worship Center. Come and take a taste of Divine Destiny Worship Center, because Expo is we 2017. Now I'm going to allow you to take a sneak peek at some of our exhibitors who will be here showcasing their talents, their gifts, and their businesses.
The Bible declares that he has raised us up together and has made us sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Hello, my name is Francine Britton, and as we prepare for Expo is we 2017, please help me welcome Stacy Charles. Hello, Stacy.
Hi.
Tell me the name of your business.
The name of my business is Transforming Spaces.
Transforming Spaces. Tell me the concept behind Transforming Spaces.
The concept came from where we do unique lamps. We take specific different things that you wouldn't think of, and we make lamps. So the tagline of that is, we do lamps.
We do lamps. And you keep saying we. Who's this we?
My husband and I, we do lamps. We do lamps came from the Lord, spoke to me, and he said, when I do what I do, it's an ornament. When he do his part, it's a functioning lamp. And that's where we get we do lamps.
So you're telling me that regardless of whatever you use, the lamp works. It's a functioning lamp.
That's right.
That's great. So what can we expect when we visit your booth as Expo is we 2017?
Well, when you visit my booth, I expect that you have an experience you never had before, seeing stuff you probably have around your house, a lot of unique stuff that we could actually make a lamp out of.
Wow. You must visit Expo is We 2017, and when you do, make sure to visit Transforming Spaces, because they do lamps.
The Bible declares that he has raised us up together and has made us sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
My name is Francine Britton, and as we get ready for Expo is Me 2017, help me welcome Malaika Matthew.
Hello.
Hello, Malaika.
Hi, Francine.
And hello, Miss Nicolette.
Hello.
Malaika, tell me the name of your business.
The name of my business is Shades Of, as in shades of pink, shades of green.
and explain to me the concept of Shades Up.
Well, it's a face painting business, and we provide services to a number of categories of people. Churches, camps, institutions for their sports and family days, product launches, you name it, Shades Up can assist you with that program.
So when I visit your booth at ExpoSV 2017, what am I going to get? What am I going to see?
In addition to examples of images, which I will do on the day, you can also get information concerning possible concepts that I can bring to an event that you are having, as well as discounts, because we're going to have a little tab and you can pull some discounts for your next event.
I like the sound of that discount. And I hope you're looking at beautiful Nicolette's face. I like that. I will be visiting Shades of
Divine Destiny Worship Center's program. This program, it's your date with destiny. You will hear.
So it also requires, from the leadership point of view, to be aware of yourself and your strengths and your weaknesses, because this is where the consciousness of your incompetence needs to be given some consideration.
Rio Claro, we are coming. Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, is coming to Rio Claro and environs on September the 6th, that's Wednesday, going right down to September the 8th, that's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We are going to be having 3 nights of powerful deliverance services under the caption, "He came to set the captives free." These meetings will be held at the Dade Village Community Center. The Dade Village Community Center, right on the main road, on Dade Village Road, the Tabaki Road. Listen to me, you cannot miss it. On the way to Rio Claro proper, we will be there from 6:30 p.m. every evening, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. He came to set the captives free. Why not call our number right now, 633-3780, to ask for further details. Amen. We are looking forward to you being there. Bring the sick, bring the demon possessed, bring those who practice necromancy, bring those who have gone crazy, bring everyone. It's going to be an awesome time. We came to set the captives free. Rio Claro and environment at the Dade Village Community Center, September 6th, 7th, 8th, 2017. God bless you. Looking forward to seeing you. Until we meet again, I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan. On behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, declaring to you, you began life as a winner. Don't live it as a victim or die as a loser. You're a God idea. Because when God made you, he had destiny on his mind. See you again at Divine Destiny Worship Center, and certainly at the exhibition. God bless you. Amen.
You continue to reach your goals through Jesus Christ. This has been It's Your Date with Destiny, a production of Divine Destiny Media Ministry. Until next time, you began life as a winner. Don't live life as a victim or die as a loser. For when God made you, he had destiny on his mind.